Where Are You Going, Baby Lincoln by Kate DiCamillo. I'm going to begin with a brief description of the characters. Baby is an endearing, naive old lady who has never had to think for herself because her older sister micromanages her entire life, and Baby does whatever her sister tells her to do. Eugenia is Baby's older sister. She is a crotchety older woman. She's domineering. She does not believe in doing anything frivolous. Everything always has to be serious. There has to be a task and a timeline for everything. There's a fictional character within the fictional book called Detective Spigot. He is a character in the book that Eugenia is making Baby read. The detective is just like Eugenia. He even looks like her. Baby continues to think about this detective throughout the entire book. She does that because he's a stand-in for Eugenia, although she doesn't realize that at the very beginning. Here's a brief description of the plot. The book begins inside of Baby's dream. She's going on a journey on a train. She doesn't know where she's going, but she says it's a necessary journey. In the dream, she enjoys the journey, even though she doesn't know where she's headed. Eugenia wakes her up abruptly and starts telling her all the things she's going to do. She tells her to keep a list of all the errands she's going to run. Baby thinks for a minute, and for the first time in her life, she tells Eugenia no. Then she says she's going on a necessary journey, and she packs her suitcase. She walks out the door and goes to the train station. She buys a ticket and gets on the train. Each chapter, she meets a new character. Each new character exposes her to new things, the comics in the newspaper, jelly beans. And each character indirectly nudges her to realize that she can't live her life for her sister. She has to figure out who she is, and she has to live her life herself. In the last chapter, she's back at home with Eugenia, doing the things that she loves to do, not what her sister tells her to do. The focus here is connecting different parts of the story. Students will need to use what they learn about Baby's relationship with Eugenia in the early chapters to help them figure out Baby's motivation later in the story. From here, my recommendation is to go into the lesson plan and quickly read the focus question exemplar response for the entire book. After that, you should be all set to teach this book. One additional note. The author, Kate DiCamillo, purposefully uses vocabulary words that are far above the reading level of this book. This is part of her craft as an author. She's catering to a child and an adult, kind of like Shrek or Coco, the movies, the children's movies. Because this vocabulary is so far above the reading level, and because vocabulary and context isn't a reading habit until steps 11 and 12, there is a vocabulary guide in the student work on the back of every single focus question. You should let students know that when they read a word, but they don't know what it means, they should check the vocabulary guide on the reverse side of the paper.